Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you very much for remaining for the last session. My name is Adrian Stoyan. I'm a trainer and consultant from TechReady. I'm happy to present a session on how to deliver an enterprise mobility suite proof of concept. First, I would like to thank to our sponsors and partners which make this conference possible. And we will begin by taking a look at the mobile device management market, because this is about mobility, how we manage mobile devices. And the first question that you may ask is, what is Enterprise Mobility Suite? If you attended Adnan Hendrik's session yesterday, you may already know the answer. It's a bundle of cloud services provided by Microsoft. Maybe the most important component is the Microsoft Intune, which is an online service to manage mobile devices. In the Enterprise Mobility Suite, Microsoft also included Azure Active Directory Premium, which provides additional functionality for authentication, for reporting, for, let's say, advanced features in managing users and devices. And also, in Enterprise Mobility Suite, you have Azure Rights Management Service, which is an implementation of rights management. You may remember that Microsoft had an on-premise implementation of RMS. Now they implemented the similar functionality for the cloud. So basically, you can restrict permissions to access content, by example, documents, Office documents, or other type of documents, based on the identity. So these two, Azure Active Directory Premium and Azure Rights Management Services, are going together, because first the user has to be authenticated, and then you give permissions to access the specific content. And the RMS uses encryption to protect the content of the document. And of course, we started this session by discussing about mobile device management, but usually it's more than that, because it's about how you manage applications, so mobile application management. How do you protect data? We just discussed about RMS. How do you manage identities in the cloud? Because when you have a lot of users that have to access various applications and resources, you have to manage the identities of those users. On the on-premise, you have Windows Active Directory. And in cloud, you have Azure Active Directory. And also how you provide secure access to information. How do you control access? How you ensure information protection? Right now, Microsoft is integrating Intune and consoles in Office 365. And the reason for doing this is because Office 365 is more and more frequently used by many companies. And it's very frequent the following scenario. The company already has Office 365 as a service, and they also want to manage mobile devices. So it makes sense to integrate the consoles together. And also a lot of Intune features, such as conditional access for Exchange and for SharePoint, depend on Office 365 for implementation. So these services are actually working together. A little bit of overview of the market. This is since last year, because this year Gartner didn't publish yet the magic quadrants. You know, this type of evaluations of the market, which put the vendors in the niche players, visionaries, leaders, and challengers. And this very much depends on vision and the ability to execute. So these are the two axes. And Microsoft was positioned as a leader for the 11th consecutive year for client management tools. So basically tools for managing desktops, laptops, so basically, let's say, client operating systems. And the product is, of course, System Center Configuration Manager, which is pretty mature product. It started back what year was it? 2000 with SMS 2.0 and SMS 2003, and then 2007. Now it's 2012 R2, And we, of course, we will have a 2016 version. Right now we have a technical preview. So this is a very mature product, and Microsoft is well positioned in this respect. However, for enterprise mobility, Microsoft is a new entrant. So last year, they managed to enter the magic quadrant for enterprise mobility, and you can see it here, in the visionary quadrant. And the reason for that, because they don't have install base, because they just entered the market a few years ago with Microsoft Intune, and compared with other vendors such as AirWatch, Mobile Iron, IBM Mobility as a Service, Good, Citrix, and so on, they don't have a very big install base, but they are working on that. So, but still, at the feature and the vision level, it's at the same level with the others, just need to work on implementations, I guess. And one additional magic quadrant is for identity and access management. And why is identity important? Because when you are talking about managing mobile devices, you also have to ensure how do you manage access to information for the users that are actually using those devices to access email, documents, and so on. So identity management is very important. You cannot just do mobile device management without identity management. And here, Microsoft, I would say, is very well positioned because of Azure Active Directory. And that's another reason why Microsoft included Azure Active Directory Premium in the Enterprise Mobility Suite, because then with Azure Active Directory, you can control access to resources, you can deploy applications based on user identity, you can give access to information in email, by example, in Exchange or in SharePoint or in various other applications. And you can also integrate with single sign-on with third-party applications. I will show you later the catalog of applications in Azure Active Directory Premium with which Microsoft has integration. And this provides the users a seamless experience. You just sign in on the device and you can access all your documents, all your emails, or all your information in a secure way. So I would say because of this, Microsoft is well positioned and eventually will move in the leaders quadrant. A little bit of Intune news. In the last year, since I delivered my last presentation here at ITCamp, a lot of things have happened. So Microsoft is improving the service every month. So if you look now, and if you look maybe in a few weeks, you will see that the interface is changing, you see new options and so on. So I was doing last year several proof of concepts for enterprise customers in Bucharest, also in Cluj, Satu Mare, and so on. And I was producing documents for them. So by example, for each customer, I produced a customized document, how to implement Intune, how to implement, various features such as policies, profiles, and so on. The big issue was for me that the interface was changing every month. So I had to produce a new document every time and change the screen capture and so on, because a lot of features have been added. So since last year, several Office mobile applications have been provided for Android. Also, you will see later for iOS. And the good news is that you can manage those applications. Those are managed applications. This means that you can control using policies the configuration of those applications the similar way that you control, by example, the Office configuration with group policies in a local domain. You can do this on mobile devices, and not only on Microsoft platform, but on Android, iOS, and so on. I will not go through all of this because this is for reference only. I will just do a highlight. By example, last year in May, it was added support for management of Windows 10, but using OMADM. This is the mobile way of managing devices. So instead of managing Windows 10 as a desktop operating system, it is managing it with OMADM protocol, like a tablet or a phone. So because of that, you can treat all the devices with Windows 10 in a unified way. And you can create policy that applies to all of the devices, regardless of the platform or and so on. So you can either treat Windows 10 as a normal operating system in a local domain, or you can treat it like a mobile device on the internet. Several others features, like by example, company portal. I will show you this in just a few minutes. This is an application that you can install on the mobile device, and then the user can go there and see which applications have been deployed and other resources. Outlook applications for iOS and Android. And again, we are talking here about managed versions. So basically, you can control the configuration of this application via policies. And multi-identity support, so the ability to manage multiple users on the same device. Not sure it's useful, but you can do this. So if multiple users are using the devices, such as in kiosk mode, you have several tablets in the secretary area, and you want several users are logging in from there, you can allow every user to check his email or something like that. And then conditional access for Windows PC to Office 365. Previously, this was available only for mobile devices, but this was added also for Windows desktop operating system. So by example, when a user tries to verify its email, the conditions from the access policies are applied. So by example, checks if the firewall is enabled, if it's an antivirus installed and it's running, and so on. So you can put conditions for that device, and in particular for the client applications, for example, Outlook for reading email. So before they can read email, they have to be compliant with the conditions that you specify in the policy. And I will show you this in the interface in a short while. Then we have, I mentioned this already, the integration of the Intune account portal in Office 365. Because previously this was a separate console, and it was a little bit weird to have the same information in two different places. So right now you can manage the accounts in a single place in Office 365, and this applies also to Intune. So basically you can use a single console to manage all the accounts. Then support for new versions of the operating system. Typically Microsoft works with third-party providers to provide support in Intune for management, for iOS 9, for Android Marshmallow. This was in October last year when these versions have appeared. So they were supported being managed with Intune from day zero. Then in January, we have support for new Windows 10 features. We have, by example, support for corporate-owned device scenarios. By example, when a user enrolls a device in Intune, the user can specify whether the device is private-owned or company-owned. Because if it's private-owned, you cannot do a lot of management. It's user personal device. You just want to publish some applications, maybe. But if it's company-owned, you have full support for all the policies and features and so on. So this is a decision that the user has to do. How, when it's enrolling his device, is this device my own or is the company device? And then we have additional applications for which are also mobile enabled. By example, Skype for Business, Dynamics CRM, Adobe Reader, which can be installed on all three platforms. And then they can be managed with Intune. So you can control the settings for these devices using Intune. In March, Microsoft published additional documentation. It also provides support for iOS 9.3, several other features for conditional access, and so on. And finally, in May, so this month, they published a new website for Microsoft Intune documentation. So previously this was based in TechNet, but right now it's a separate site. And I would like to just show you this. So here you have all the Intune documentation in a single place. So the address is docs.microsoft.com/n-us and Intune. So you have everything in a single location right now, because previously it was a little bit difficult to find all the Intune documents. And coming back to the topic of this presentation, let's see why would you like to implement a proof of concept. And the reason would be that by performing a proof of concept in your own environment or in a lab environment will allow you to get the first-hand experience with the features. And as I mentioned before, the features are changing. Every month, new features are added. So the best way to get to know the product is by actually trying to implement it. And that actually is pretty simple, because everything is online. You go sign in for a trial Enterprise Mobility Suite subscription, and then you start enrolling devices. And then you play with various policies and profiles and so on. So the rest of the presentation is how do you approach proof of concept. And these are the typical, let's say, activities that you will do. First, you create the trial subscription. Then you enroll some devices. I typically have an Android device and a Windows mobile device, a Windows 10 workstation, and various others if you need to test others. And then you configure device settings using policies. You can configure VPN profiles, wireless profiles, email profiles. What is this all about? It's about automatically configuring settings on the managed devices. So you can configure automatically a VPN connection for the users. You can configure the wireless network, by example, to authenticate using certificates. You can enroll for certificates. You can configure the settings for the email accounts and so on. So from the Intune console, you can apply all these settings to the managed devices. If you have System Center Configuration Manager on-premise, you can also integrate those with Intune using the Intune connector. And I will explain later how you can do this. In the next section, I will discuss the cloud-only implementation. So everything is managed from the cloud, from the Microsoft data centers. And of course, you have Microsoft Intune service. And the Microsoft Intune is tied to an Azure Active Directory directory service, so an identity management solution in the cloud. And of course, tied to the same Azure Active Directory, we have Office 365, because we have a single set of users. There's no reason to have separate directories. So it's like having a single domain. And then you have both Intune and Office 365 using identity management solution. For some features, especially for enabling Azure Active Directory Premium and Azure Rights Management Service, we still have to use Azure Portal, because those features are exposed only in the Azure Portal. And you can manage mobile devices from Android, iOS, Windows Phone, and also Windows 10 as a mobile device, and also desktops from Windows. I still believe they offering support for Windows XP to be managed as a device. Even the operating system is not officially supported anymore. But you can still enroll it in Intune if you want. So what's the first step? It's creating a trial enterprise management subscription. There are various ways of doing this. If you have Office 365, and many companies already have, the easiest way is to add the services, the additional services, to your existing subscription, because then they will be automatically tied to your Azure Active Directory, instance. And you configure Azure Active Directory Premium, you configure Azure Rights Management Services, and so on. If you have a volume licensing contract, and many companies have acquired Office 365 through a volume license agreement, then the best way is to work with your software vendor, the software provider, to add Enterprise Mobility Suite to your contract if you want to purchase. So that would be the official way. However, if you just want to do a trial, I suggest you do not tie to your existing Office 365. You just go and create a trial EMS subscription, totally independent from your environment, so isolated from your domain, isolated from your Office 365, and you just create a 30-day trial for for Enterprise Mobility Suite. And now we have a new wizard to do that. The next step would be to perform device enrollment. And this is specific for every type of device. By example, right now it's for Windows Phone 8.1, so the previous version. So you go to the workplace, you say add account, and then you specify your email address, basically. This, if you have implemented the Federation services, or if you implemented Dear Sync, you can synchronize it with your local Active Directory domain, so the user can use his username and password, basically his email address and password. And then you sign in with those credentials, and you can see that the account was added, and now the device is managed by Microsoft Intune, so pretty easy experience. You may also want to add the company portal, which is a store application. You go to the Microsoft Windows Phone Store, and you add the company portal, you install it, you sign in with your Microsoft account, and after the company portal was installed, you will see it and you can sign in again. And then here you can see various information, such as, by example, the applications that have been published by the administrator, or you can manage your other devices. So, by example, if you have a tablet and a phone and you lost your phone, you can remote wipe your phone from the tablet, or things like this, if you want, of course. The idea is, even if someone gets the hand on the device, at least they don't have access to your information. That's the idea of remote wipe. And you can see also which policies have been applied and other settings. So this is useful if you want to see and access resources that are published by your company. You can also enroll Windows 10 devices. I mentioned before that you can manage Windows 10 operating system as a mobile device. So, by example, you have a tablet with Windows 10, and you can manage it as a mobile device instead of a desktop or laptop, whatever you want to consider it. First, you have to enable Azure Active Directory Premium, because this is a premium feature. I'm signing in here in Windows Azure. I specify that I want to manage my existing directory. So basically, from the Azure console, I'm connecting to my Azure Active Directory, let's say, instance, which is tied to Office 365 and Intune. And I say I want to manage this Azure Active Directory instance from Azure portal. I said before that some of the features, such as Azure Active Directory Premium and Azure RMS, are managed through the Azure portal, not through the Office 365 or Intune portals. And after that, I have to accept that my Azure Active Directory instance will be managed from Microsoft Azure. And then I sign out and sign in again, and then I can access my directory through Azure portal. This is useful, especially, by example, if you are a partner and you are delivering services for multiple companies. You can manage all their directories from a single portal. So you are connecting to the Azure portal, and from the Azure portal, you can see all their directories. Of course, those are not real. You don't believe that I really have access to those customers, but I deliver proof of concept for them. So I have several, let's say, mock directories created. Those do not have any connection to the real environments of those customers. And then you enable Azure Active Directory Premium, and here I activate a trial. And after that, I enable the premium features for several users. So I go to each individual user for which I want to enable the Azure Active Directory premium trial and enable that for them. And the last step is to publish Microsoft Intune as an application to those, let's say, users. So when they enroll a device, by example, when they join the Azure Active Directory domain, they automatically get the Intune application deployed. Okay? Did I mention that you can join Windows 10 to Azure Active Directory? It's like joining a local domain, but instead you are joining the cloud domain, the Azure Active Directory instance. So let me show you how you can do that. So here you can see that I can go to the Windows 10 operating system. This is just a standard operating system. It's not the tablet version or whatever. So I go here to the system, connect to work or school, and you can see here the two options. The first one is join a domain, which is a Windows Active Directory domain, an on-premise domain. And the second one is join Azure Active Directory. What is the difference? The first one works on Kerberos. The second one works on internet protocols, because Kerberos doesn't work on the internet. So it uses OAuth and other HTTP-based protocol to join Azure Active Directory. So until now, in Azure Active Directory, you had users and groups. But now you can have also devices, Windows 10 devices and future versions. So you can manage them from the cloud instead of using a local Active Directory domain. And you sign in with the credentials, and it's joining the Azure Active Directory. And after it does that, it will automatically deploy the Intune application. So the device is managed. So you can control all the settings on the Windows 10 operating system via Intune as a mobile device. So that's the new, let's say, set of features in Windows 10. Then you go ahead and configure additional policies and settings. And I will just demonstrate several of them, just to give you an impression what you can do with Microsoft Intune. By example, you can do typical policies such as password policies, configure encryption on device, disabling hardware access, by example, disabling access to camera, to GPS, and other options. Actually, this is the first demo. Let me quickly go to the Intune portal. And first I will show you the portals, so you to have an impression which consoles do you have available for managing Microsoft Intune. This is the old portal, the old account portal, and you can see here that is merging with the Office 365, and this eventually will be removed. It's still here, but not for long. And of course, you go here to users, by example. Let's see if it requires me to authenticate. Yes, it times out after a period of inactivity. Okay. And then I can see the users that are created here. I just created a few of them just for demo purposes. And if I go here, by example, this is my user account. You can see here that I'm enrolled in Enterprise Mobility Suite, so I have all the features enabled for this this account. And I can configure various other settings. Since it is my own account and I'm also the administrator, it doesn't enable me to do this, but I can do this for the other users. Then I have the Intune portal, the management portal, admin portal, how it's called. And here you can see an overview of all the areas that are available, policies, devices, and so on. Let's go, by example, to the groups and see which devices. Again, I have to re-authenticate. Hopefully, we'll. Let's see. And shortly, I will see again the console and see the groups. And here I can see, by example, the devices that I have enrolled in my Intune subscription. So just a few moments until it decides to come back. In the meantime, I will show you the Office console. So you can see here that tied to the same Azure Active Directory account, I also have an Office 365 trial subscription. So here I can also configure various settings. So coming back to the account, the admin portal, I can go to, by example, to all mobile devices and take a look which devices I have enrolled. And if everything is all right, I can see here an Android device. And I can view the properties for this tablet. And you can see that I try to configure to policy settings, and this give me an error because that policy settings didn't apply to that device. It's an old model. It's a tablet that I have for demo purposes. And then I can see the hardware. It's old version of Android. And I can also see which policies are applied to this particular device. So minimum password length, require a password, allow mobile devices to sign in. So one of them failed for because it didn't apply to that device. And of course, you can create various policies. I have here a configuration policy, which I created earlier. So it's called default company policies. And I can take a look here. It's just some standard settings which apply to most platforms. And this is general settings. We have more specific settings available in other policies. So it's a default company policy, require the password to unlock, and you can see the support for various platforms. And then whether password length, whether allow simple password, and various other settings, password expiration. I can enable encryption, and this is depending on the device, if the device supports encryption or not. And various settings for updates, for lock screen, for this again depends very much on the support offered by the device. Then the ability to save documents and data to cloud. Whether we can configure a Microsoft account or a Google account on that device. And if I set this policy, I can say, no, the user doesn't have the ability to enroll his device in Google, by example, for security reasons, or to Microsoft for the same security reason. And email, there is a separate email policy. I will show you later that. Browser settings I can configure. Applications, access to application stores, gaming, I can disable camera. The users will be upset if I do this. So basically, they cannot take photos and videos anymore. And then enable or disable wireless, NFC, Bluetooth, and so on. And these are general settings. The applicability for this is depending very much on the device because, by example, voice assistant applies to iOS and Samsung Knox, which is an add-on for Android, which provides management capabilities for Android operating system, but it's a paid add-on, and so on. So this very much depends on the capability of device, and when you try to configure the settings, it will tell you on which platforms it is supported. So before applying, check whether that feature is supported on that particular version and operating system. Then I can configure even more policies, but let's get back to the presentation because we will discuss about VPN profiles, wireless profiles, and email profiles. And these are useful if you want to deploy various settings on the devices so the user don't have to configure all these settings manually. For many of these settings, you may need to use certificates, and this is the first topic here in this section. And you can do certificate enrollment automatically on the managed devices. How you can do that? By example, you can have a certification authority inside your company network, so sitting behind the firewall. You have to publish that certification authority through let's say proxy, which is using simple certificate enrollment protocols, CHEP, to receive a request from the device and then pass the request to the certification authority. And then the certification authority will enroll the certificate, give it back, and the certificate will get to the device, and the device will install it. So this is automatically over the internet. You just have to configure a policy via Intune to tell the device, hey, you should enroll for a certificate, and here it's where you connect to request a certificate. So using this feature, you can enroll for certificates from a certification authority that is sitting on the company network, but via the internet, and the protocol is based on HTTPS, so it's secure. So you can deploy certificates automatically on the devices. You don't have to install them manually on each telephone or tablet. Then you can configure VPN profiles. You can configure the settings for the users to establish a VPN connection to the company network, and you configure even authentication with certificates and various other security settings for those VPN tunnel. You can configure wireless, so if you want, when the users are coming to the company network, to be connected automatically to the wireless. Then you, again, you configure the settings, you can even configure authentication with certificates and encryption and so on, using the supported protocols, and when this policy will apply to the devices, and when the devices will reach the company network, will connect automatically to the wireless. And you can also configure email settings. This is an extra policy which provides more specific configuration details. For connecting via ActiveSync or IMAP, and you can configure various settings for that. Let me show you how you can do that. I will go to the Intune again, and here you have various configuration policies, and I will add a new policy, and let's select for Android, because I already have an Android device enrolled. I can, by example, deploy a certificate, and I will show you this, how you, by example, deploy trusted root cert. And here I have to import a PFX file, which I have maybe on the local disk, and automatically this certificate will be deployed to the devices. So I don't have right now a PFX file, but I will show you also how you can configure the same for Android, the CEP certificate profile. So after you deploy the trusted root CA certificate, so the device will trust all the certificates issued by that certification authority, you can configure policies to enroll for additional certificates, and you can go here and specify again, by example, user cert. And you have to specify the address of the proxy will pass back this, the certificate request to the certification authority. And then you specify how the request will be made, including common name or email address and validity period, and what will be used, by example, for encryption and digital signature, the hash algorithm, extended key usage, and here I can select for various extended key usage, and so on. So this all will be included in the request, and the request will go through that proxy to the certification authority. The certification authority will issue the certificate, will pass it back to the device, and the device will install it automatically. So this is how you enroll for certificates. Then I will show you how you create, by example, a VPN profile. So you can configure automatically the VPN settings on the devices. I will create a policy here, VPN connection. And here you can see company VPN, let's say a name that will be seen by the users. And you can see here that we have support for various type of VPN devices, including Cisco, F5, Dell Sonic, or Checkpoint. Interesting enough, for the Android, we don't have Microsoft VPN protocols. I guess it's natural, but we will see it in the other section. And then VPN server name and IP address, authentication methods, and here you can see that it can use the certificates that we have previously enrolled for authenticating for the VPN connection and select which certificate to use. Let me show you also the wireless. So again, for Android, a Wi-Fi profile, and here you can see, let's say, Wi-Fi settings. And let's see for which network. Here I have to enter network name and SSID. This is a bogus wireless. Connect automatically. Connect even if it's not broadcasting the SSID, and then authentication. And here it's the support for authentication and for EAP type. By example, I can use AEP TLS, and here I can configure certificates for authentication. So basically, when it connects to the wireless network, it will authenticate with the certificate that was previously deployed to the device. So you can control the settings for this wireless connection. Then we have email policies. Let me show you also this, also for Android. An email profile, but you see that for this is requiring that add-on from Samsung Knox. So Android by default doesn't have support for email active sync policies based on active sync. But you have this on other operating systems such as iOS. And here you can have, by example, email profile. And of course, for Windows, so for Windows Phone, Windows 10, and so on, you can configure email profile here. So by example, if I decide to configure it for Windows Phone 8, you can see here applicability, the name of the ActiveSync host, how the account name is built for using user principal name or email address, synchronization settings, what will be synchronized, and so on. So you can control the settings via policies in Intune. Some of the new features, we have compliance policies. This is something similar with desired configuration management in System Center. So by example, you define a specific configuration. And if the device is not compliant, you report first. And you can also block access. For this, we have conditional access section. By example, if the device is not compliant, doesn't have various settings, security settings applied, then you block access to Exchange, to SharePoint, or other resources, so the device cannot connect. Yes, so because you have different settings for Exchange, for SharePoint, for Skype, so you have separate policies. Yes, yes, definitely you can do per application conditional access. Also we have a new feature which is corporate device enrollment, which is basically bulk enrollment of corporate devices, because of course the users can enroll one by one, but when you buy 100 phones for the users, you maybe want them to be enrolled in bulk. So you can pre-provision those devices, so when the users are starting the phone, it will be go automatically and enroll. So these are the type of settings that you may control via Intune. Now coming back to the presentation, I have just mentioned conditional access, which is restricting access to company resources based on various settings. By example, restricting access to email if the device is not managed. By example, the user has a new phone, his personal phone, but the phone is not enrolled in Intune, so it's not managed. So then the user tries to connect to Exchange via ActiveSync and goes to the settings, tries to enter the email address server, the account, the password, and so on. And then the device will try to connect to the Exchange. Exchange will Exchange online or Exchange on-premise, it works for both. And the Exchange will talk back to the Intune and say, hey, this device is not enrolled, block access. So until the device is enrolled, it will not permit access to that device to the service. Regarding the integration with System Center 2012 Configuration Manager, this is a long topic and we cannot really cover it in the time that we have available. And I will just mention the configuration. So basically, what you do, you configure unified management in hybrid mode, let's say, between the Intune as a cloud service and Configuration Manager, which is residing on-premise. And this is done via the Intune connector. So you configure an Intune connector on Configuration Manager. And then, as an administrator using the Configuration Manager console, you can configure the same policies that you have seen in the Intune console, but in the Configuration Manager console. So you're using a single console to manage both on-premise devices, so the desktop operating system which are managed locally with a Configuration Manager client, and also mobile devices which are connected to Intune. And why do you need Intune? Because Intune is a cloud service provided by Microsoft, which is easily accessible by devices. And then Intune will tell those devices, hey, you have to apply these policies. But the policies came through Intune connector from the Configuration Manager console. This is what I wanted to discuss about Enterprise Mobility Suite. Of course, I didn't cover the important features such as Azure Active Directory Premium and Azure Rights Management Service. If you want to see more details about this, you can see the recording of Adnan's session, which took place yesterday, about Enterprise Mobility Suite. So he performed some demos on Azure Active Directory Premium settings. You can also take a look at various resources. There's a blog regarding to Microsoft Intune. Also, another blog from Brad Anderson, which is the vice president for the, let's say, system management and mobility division from Microsoft. And if you are interested in maybe finding out more details, I am organizing trainings, basically seminars, which can be delivered at your company premises on various topics, including mobile device management with Intune and Configuration Manager. And also, I have just published the first document from a set of guides, because I mentioned that last year I have performed several proof of concepts for enterprise customers in Romania. And I decided to publish the updated versions, because the interface changed a lot since then. So the updated guides with step-by-step, let's say, guidance on how to perform an Enterprise Mobility Suite proof of concept, starting with creating an Enterprise Mobility subscription. So if you are going right now on my blog, which is here. So you can reuse it, and of course you will have to replace the screenshots because it's my company name everywhere. So you have to do a little bit of work. Yeah, you can reuse them, no problem. That's why I publish. I decided to make it available for everyone. So the first one is on how to sign in for an Enterprise Mobility Suite subscription, a trial subscription. And this is using the new wizard, which has been made available previously. It was a little bit complicated. First, you had to sign with an Office 365 subscription, then you add the Intune, and then you go to Azure and add Azure Active Directory Premium and Azure RMS. Now it's easier. You go to the Enterprise Mobility Suite site, you sign in for a trial account, and automatically it provisions an Office 365, Intune, Azure RMS, Azure Active Directory Premium, I'm sorry. You still have to configure Azure RMS because that's something you have to do. But it's easier right now. And you can download this from my blog. And I will publish even more guides in the next weeks, including how to enroll devices, how to configure policies and profiles. So please check. I will also tweet, and you can subscribe to my tweet and account, and I will announce the new updates to the documentation. With that, I would like to thank you very much for attending this session. Hopefully it was interesting, and you find out some useful things. And hope to see you next year. Thank you very much.